Blind city collapses, owing $1.9 million. Let's have a look. Hello everyone, Florian Heiser here and welcome to another episode of Heiser Says. Grab your stein of coffee and let's have a look at this article from news.com.au about another business collapsing and owing millions of dollars with many customers frustrated. So Melbourne company collapses owing $1.9 million with 75 customers impacted. So, and it was, hang on, I'll make sure you can see it all, Blinds City described itself as Australia's leading online store for customised and pre-made DIY window blinds, shutters and other window furnishings. So they collapsed owing $1.95 million to 140 creditors, with the director of the business overwhelmed by its failure, according to the liquidator. Oh, no. Its demise has impacted 75 customers who are collectively owed $142,000 after paying a deposit and not receiving their goods, the liquidator told news.com.au. And if we jump over to this screen, we can see, this is product reviews, and this is Blind City, and you can see they had a pretty good review rating. But now negative one stars are starting to appear. Here's a comment from Adele. Ordered blinds, paid over $2,000 deposit. Couldn't get in touch with them. Shocking communication. Now disconnected their phones. Complete con man. Well, not really. They were already going under. But it probably depends on how long ago you ordered. I just want to cry. Today my curtains were due to be installed after 10 weeks. 10 weeks. Women love their curtains. Booked it last Wednesday with final payment made on Thursday as instructed and per conditions. As soon as I paid the final amount, no one would return my calls to confirm time for today. Had three numbers for them and left heaps of messages and just called all three numbers an hour ago and disconnected. Yeah, so there you go. So they were still. So they made Thursday, and this was published 4 days ago. So last week, Robin paid, they were still taking money. So is that trading while insolvent? Did they know they were going under and still taking money from people? They knew they were going but still collected money from hardworking families. This is a scam. Absolute disgrace. So same thing here. So it looks like they were taking payment as of last week, and you should know by then that you're going under. So this is where some of the big builders that shut down 1 year before they were collapsing, they knew the writing was on the wall. They could still pay their staff. They could pay their suppliers. It can be much worse. And unfortunately, I think we will see more of this. So, Eddie Muscat of Mayfield's Business Advisors was appointed as liquidator on August the 1st. So, at the beginning of this month, like 20 days ago, they already had a liquidator. Why were they still taking orders or payments? The company's failure has also hit 12 employees who are owed outstanding entitlements, Mr. Muscat said. He's still gathering evidence to determine what went wrong with the company. The director has been overwhelmed by the failure, has not yet provided statutory required information sought from him. On August 19, we negotiated a settlement with the landlord, which will enable the liquidator to recover the books and records from the premises and deal with the customers whose stock is on site. The liquidator will be seeking assistance from ASIC if the director remains unwilling or unable to assist. Let's hope this person, the director of this business, that they don't do anything stupid. Okay? Let's hope they don't check out, because it's not worth it, okay? It's not worth it. It's just money. It's just blinds. Rebuild. Don't do anything stupid. And, I mean, for men, this is it. You know, losing a business, losing something that's such a big part of your identity, that what you've built up. I mean, your success is part of your entire identity. It's part of you getting a partner as a man often. A number of customers have left comments on review sites claiming they're thousands of dollars out of pocket. Others claim they'd waited weeks for blinds to be installed only to discover later that the company's phones have been disconnected. Blind City's website and social media accounts have been taken down. A massive rise in company collapses. Well, yeah. There's no secret there's been a massive rise in Australian companies collapsing, but recent findings showed they've skyrocketed a whopping 50% since April. Well, yes, they have. But remember, they collapsed. The actual number of collapses collapsed. And external liquidators appointed collapsed. because they allowed businesses to trade while insolvent a few years ago, and money was just flooding businesses everywhere. The construction sector has been plagued by dozens of companies folding this year, caused by a perfect storm of supply chain disruptions, skill shortages, skyrocketing costs of materials and logistics, and extreme weather events. Tech companies in particular are also struggling in Australia, with investors spooked by dramatic plunges in valuations, making funding harder to find. The latest tech outfit to be impacted was a Melbourne-based esports company called Order, which raised $5.3 million in funding last year, but collapsed last week, with liquidators seeking to sell the business urgently. Then there was an Australian tech company called Medigy, which left staff shell-shocked by its sudden collapse early this month after it planned to raise money with a valuation of $1 billion. But, I mean, that just shows you how stupid some of these valuations are. Last month, it was Vault went under. 6,000 customers were told to withdraw their funds, but at least they didn't lose their funds. It could be much worse. From delivery startup to influencer brands. Other failed businesses include delivery service Send, which went into liquidation at the end of May, $11 million in 8 months to stay afloat. See, these are all desperate stories. Victorian food delivery company styled itself as a rival to Uber Eats and Deliveroo. Collapsed in July as it became unprofitable. I mean, is Uber Eats even profitable? Is Uber even profitable? Hasn't even made any money yet? I don't think it has. They're just chucking more and more money at it. Despite making more than $6 million worth of delivery since it launched in 2017 and had 18,000 customers. Yeah, but did you make any profit on those deliveries? It doesn't mean anything unless you're making a profit. Maybe this is the dose of reality that we're finally starting to see. Businesses have to be profitable. People aren't just going to chuck money at any brand new startup hoping it's going to be the next big thing. There was also a popular Australian e-commerce eyewear brand, Soda Shades, which collapsed owing $2.3 million due to tough market conditions brought about by the COVID-19 pandemic. Well, we have, and before that, in 2019, we were talking about the retail recession, everyone, where retailers were going down left, right, and center. And some of the bigger ones have survived, and they've got a lot of money, but the little ones, the mum and dads, a lot of them are doing it real tough or disappeared. So let's have a talk about this. Another business collapsed, millions, nearly 2 million owed to people, employees done over, customers done over, and a director that's just struggling. This is just a disaster. The only thing we can hope is the people involved in this get their money back. You know, they manage to liquidate it and the orders get sorted. People don't lose too much and the director, frankly, doesn't do anything stupid. It's just blinds. You can start again. Anyway, thanks for watching. Like, share, subscribe to the channel. Let me know your thoughts and opinions on this one. I want to draw your attention to my two other channels, Heiser Bim and Heiser Says International. Make sure to check them out if you haven't already. And take care, guys. If you want to support us here, there are a few ways you can. Financially via YouTube or Patreon, using our referral links at Amazon, eBay, Independent Reserve, or Aussie Broadband, buying our merch, or calling us if you need an architect. Take care. Have a great day. I'll see you in the next episode. Blinds aren't cheap, though. They're expensive. I wonder if there were supply chain issues affecting the ability to deliver or skyrocketing costs. Be interesting to pull this one apart and see what happens.